Europe is braced for more record-breaking temperatures this weekend as a heatwave intensifies. In Greece, it's reached 40 degrees Celsius, forcing the authorities to close the Acropolis in Athens for a second day.
People are being advised to avoid direct sunlight between 11 a.m. and 6 p.m.
The heat wave this past summer was the most severe I've ever seen.
It was so hot that you couldn't even breathe.
Athens is a very densely populated and very densely built city, with not very many green spaces, so it makes it really vulnerable to heat.
Heat affects human health in the short and in the long term. In the short term, you may feel nauseous or exhausted, or even have a heat stroke, which is a serious situation. In the long term, your blood will get thicker because of dehydration, and when it passes through the kidneys, it will injure them.
The projections for heat for the city of Athens are quite grim. The heat waves will increase in intensity, in frequency, and in their duration.
In our studies, we measure how heat affects people's physiology. We measure, for example, skin temperature. We measure core temperature deep inside our body. We assess all these and try to see how our body reacts to all this heat that's being exposed to. In addition to our measurements in the lab, we venture out in the field to see the real-world impact of our work, but sometimes we're surprised seeing that people are more affected.
The city becomes particularly hot during a heat wave because of the constructive materials like cement and concrete. The heat is then re-radiated back to the environment, resulting in high temperatures. The University of Athens conducted a study with respect to the impact of heat waves on houses in a less developed part of the city. The houses that were selected didn't have insulation, they didn't have air conditioning. During the heat wave, the average temperature in the houses was 35 degrees centigrade. By the end of the heat wave, the temperature increased to 39 degrees.
We need to adapt to heat and make Athens a more resilient place for people to work and live.
We need to adapt cities both in the short and in the long term. In the short term, we need to build better early warning systems to warn people earlier. For citizens, they are important to plan their day-to-day activities. For workers and corporations, they're even more important because they need a lot more time to prepare in advance so that they can protect their workforce. In the long term, we need to adapt the way cities are built and use nature-based solutions to minimize the impact of urban heat islands.
You need to have more greenery, practically everywhere possible, at the top of the buildings, at the street level, at empty spaces. In addition to this, you need more shading, better insulated buildings, and less cars, especially at the city center.
Our vision is to increase the permeable and green spaces of the city of Athens to 30%. For health reasons, for well-being reasons, and to keep the city cooler.